You feel that, oh, if only my family is there, I have my family to suffer with me, iftar with me, it's different. I just went for my first uni class, and there was this sister in class, like her name was Mariam. She was like this lady in hijab, and she just like asked me to join her group. So I was surprised, like, because I had tattoos and I was wearing really short, so I was quite surprised. After that we became friends, like really close. She was like a big sister to me, but she never ever discussed about religion to me. But it was through her character that I was like, I thought to myself, is it because of her religion that she is who she is? So because of that, yeah, I got curious. And just one random day, I asked her, does she have any books for me to read? And
about Islam?
Yeah, about Islam. I feel that I am very blessed. I did a little prayer in my heart. If Allah is real, show me. So he really sent me in different stages of my life. He sent me different people. So after Mariam, I met a guy who is my current partner. Whenever I had questions, he was like my Google. He would answer for me. If he didn't know, he would search for me. And then through the years, I met his family. And then they would guide me, especially in prayer and recitation.
When was the moment that you knew you are going to convert to Islam?
I was already attending classes at Daru. So a few days later, I had a class. So I went to ask the Ustad, do all Muslims go to heaven? His replies made me feel that Islam is the one. He told me that even if you're Muslim, doesn't mean you're guaranteed a spot in paradise. Because at the end of the day, he's not the judge of us, and it also depends on our deeds and the things we do, etc., etc. I'm actually happy that we have to actually fight for our spot in paradise. So that was like my turning point. As I was more sure of Islam, I've actually felt even lonelier. Yeah, because I didn't really have friends that I can share this similar interest with. I didn't really have like people I can talk to or ask questions besides my partner and his family. Then I met a Chinese convert whom I can relate to. Her name is Dania, and she isn't the only one. I also met Nabila, my poly friend, whom I've never really talked to, and right now we are really close. Like, we talk about anything under the sun, and especially she has helped me through Islam a lot as well.
Saya bertemu dia pada tahun kedua, di mana bila dia masuk kelas tu, dia dengan telatahnya yang semua kasar. Dia luarannya yang bertatu dan juga mukanya yang tidak senyum. Tapi dia adalah kawan saya pertama yang memulakan percakapan dengan saya. Sebab bila tahun kedua tu, saya sebenarnya menukar penampilan saya. Saya berhijab. Dan ada segelintir kawan rapat saya yang tidak setuju dan mereka tidak berkawan dengan saya lagi. Tapi Aafiya ini dia lain. Dia nampak saya, dia macam, boleh tak saya berkawan dengan awak? Boleh lihat kan, dia seorang yang prihatin dan ingin selalu banyak bertanya. Bila saya nampak IG story tu, saya fikir kenapa tidak saya menolong dia. So that's when saya membalas story-nya dan mengajak dia. Dan pada masa itu, saya juga mengikuti kursus di Al-Quran Academy. Dan banyak rakan-rakan saya suka kursus itu kerana mereka menggunakan bahasa Inggeris untuk berceramah. Dan saya rasa kenapa tidak saya membawanya.
Initially, the reason I fast, I thought that we fast because we want to feel what the poor people do. And that's what I've always thought. But this year, I started to read up more about Ramadan. And the main reason, if I'm not wrong, is that we have to control our desires. And fasting this month really changed my whole perception of Ramadan. And it's really special this year. Sometimes I feel like, because you know, you see everything on social media, people sahur, they will post what they eat. People iftar, they will post what they eat. Then they will eat with their family and all. but I have to wake up for sahur alone, and then sometimes you feel that, yeah, you tend to compare yourself with others. You feel that, oh, if only my family is there, I have my family to sahur with me, iftar with me, it's different. After learning more about Islam, I feel that family is very important. They say they are your keys to Jannah. For me, this is one of the most difficult things to do, because I was never really close to them. It has made me learn how to try to be closer to them, spend more time with them. I think as a father, I think he's just worried. Slowly right now, he's also starting to be more, like, he will buy halal food back. Yeah, and he will tell me, okay, this hot dog is halal, you can eat. A few days ago, he just cooked a soup. He just sent a picture to the group chat. He was like, this is halal soup, come back and drink. Yeah, so that really touched my heart, that he will go all out to do something like that for me.
I think for me, I would like to tell her that to never lose hope and to also to never lose faith, because everyone is here for you, and always continue to seek knowledge, because as you go in deeper, there will be many more questions and many more intriguing questions and complicated issues, and also always don't forget to ask questions and hold on to the hope of Allah, and also don't forget to always supplicate to Him.
Even though I may be pretty annoying with my questions, I really, really appreciate you and all your so much patience for me and all my questions about Islam. Thank you for all your patience. Thank you.